डॉक्टर पी के सोनी, प्रोफेसर, गवर्नमेंट बिलासा गर्ल्स पीजी कॉलेज, बिलासपुर, छत्तीसगढ़। वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर यूनिट टू ऑफ पेपर टू। द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज लैग्रेंज इक्वेशन ऑफ मैग्निफिकेशन। हियर वी आर यूजिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ लीनियर मैग्निफिकेशन एंड स्नेल्स लॉ। लीनियर मैग्निफिकेशन इज डिफाइंड एज रेशियो बिटवीन हाइट ऑफ इमेज टू हाइट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट। एंड स्नेल्स लॉ वी डिफाइन एज म्यू वन साइन आई इज इक्वल टू म्यू टू साइन आर, वेयर म्यू वन एंड म्यू टू आर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ मीडियम वन एंड टू, I is angle of incidence and R is angle of refraction. The section of a spherical surface separating the two media of refractive index mu 1 and mu 2, which is showing in the figure, having its center of curvature at C and pole at O dash is shown in figure. A ray from an axial point O is refracted at a surface O dash A dash with slope angle alpha 1. The refracted ray is A dash I with slope angle alpha 2. The point I is the image of object O. If an object OA of height h1 be placed at O, its image IV is of height h2 at I. For this we consider the ray A double dash. This ray is incident from A normally on the surface O dash A dash, and therefore this ray does not suffer any deviation and passes through center of curvature C. So IV is the image of OA. This H1 is height of object, H2 is height of image, this we are taking with minus sign as we are using sign convention. This distance of object is u and distance of image is v, this we are measuring from the pole. This is radius of curvature R. This angle alpha 1 between this is angle alpha 1, this is angle alpha 2. Here also we are using the sign convention. This is angle I between this incident ray and normal. This is angle of refraction R between this normal and refracted rays. Suppose this angle is theta. As we know, linear magnification M is equal to length of image upon length of object. This is equal to IB upon OA. This is equal to minus H2 upon H1. This we are writing from the figure. From the figure, we can write in triangle AOC and triangle BIC. IB upon OA is equal to CI upon CO is equal to O dash I minus O dash C upon OO dash plus O dash C. This is equal to, we can write V minus R upon U plus R. We are putting these values. From equation 1, we can write M is equal to IB upon OA is equal to minus H2 upon H1. This is equal to V minus R upon minus U plus R. Now we are using the concept of Snell's law. Sin I upon sin R is equal to mu 2 upon mu 1, where I is angle of incidence and R is angle of refraction. Mu 1 and mu 2 are refractive index of medium 1 and medium 2 respectively. If angle I and angle R are very small, then we can write sin I is equal to I and sin R is equal to R, because we know that sin 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, for a small angle, we can write mu 1 I is equal to mu 2 R. R mu 2 upon mu 1 is equal to I upon R. Now, from the figure, we can write A dash O dash is equal to H. Then angle A dash O O dash is equal to alpha 1. This is equal to A dash O dash upon O dash O. This is equal to H upon minus U. Triangle A dash I O dash is equal to minus alpha 2. This is equal to A dash O dash upon O dash I. This is equal to H upon B. And we can write angle A dash C O dash is equal to theta is equal to A dash O dash upon O dash C. This is equal to H upon R. Also, from the figure, we can write I is equal to theta plus alpha 1 and R is equal to theta plus alpha 2. From equation 3, we can write mu 2 upon mu 1 is equal to I upon R. This is equal to theta plus alpha 1 upon theta plus alpha 2. On putting the value of theta, alpha 1 and alpha 2, we can write H upon R plus H upon minus U upon H upon R minus H upon V. This is alpha 1, this is alpha 2 and this is theta. On solving this, we can write minus U plus R upon V minus R multiplied by V upon minus U. From equation 2 and 4, we have mu 2 upon mu 1 is equal to H1 upon minus H2 multiplied by V upon minus U. This minus minus cancel. So we can write mu 2 H2 upon mu 1 H1 is equal to B upon U. Now from the figure we can write tan alpha 1 is equal to H upon minus U. Tan minus alpha 2 is equal to H upon B. Or tan alpha 2 is equal to minus H upon B, because we write tan minus theta is equal to minus tan theta. And then this tan alpha 1 divided by this and tan alpha 2. So we can write tan alpha 1 upon tan alpha 2 is equal to H upon minus U multiplied by this minus V upon H. This minus minus cancel, and this is equal to B upon U. From equation 5 and 6, both right side are equal, so we can write left side like this: mu 2 H 2 upon mu 1 H 1 is equal to tan alpha 1 upon tan alpha 2. On cross multiplication, we can write mu 1 H 1 is equal to tan alpha 1. This is equal to mu 2 H 2 tan alpha 2. This equation is known as Lagrange equation of magnification. Thank you.